And what we can do is we can just sell the trader his own stuff. So wabam, we are now underneath Whiterun. Lovely stuff. It really is as easy as that. Then make your way to the side wall of the Falmor Embassy. Just walk up against it and wabam, you're inside the Falmor Embassy. Now, have the developers removed this chest from the game? Have they? Nope, of course they haven't. Hello there, ladies and gentlemen. I'm the Spiffing Brit. Today you join me in Skyrim Anniversary Edition. That's right, this game's now been out for 10 years. And you know what that means. The developers have had ample time to not only bug fix, but add in new features like fishing. There's just one slight problem. They actually probably haven't had enough time to bug fix because this is Bethesda. It turns out, no, 10 years is actually not enough time to fix all of the many, many hundreds of bugs and exploits that still exist in Skyrim. And today my plan is simple, to beat the entirety of the main quest of Skyrim. That's right, because whilst I have hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of hours in Skyrim, I've never beaten the main quest. Oh, don't worry, I've gotten very close. I've gotten to some of the last few missions, and then the game has glitched and softlocked me from progression. With glitches so annoying and painful, I decided I never wanted to play Skyrim again. But naturally, that lasted hardly any time at all, and I'm playing Skyrim for what is probably the 740th time. And so today, my mission is simple. Use all of the exploits in Skyrim, which I'm sure have all been patched out now that it's 10 years on, and to absolutely crush this game's main questline, using a series of absolutely overpowered and broken exploits. It's going to be a gloriously broken video, ladies and gentlemen, as we're going to be showing off a whole bunch of exploits I'm sure none of you have ever seen before. So make sure you're sat back, relaxed, you have a nice warm cup of tea in hand, and if you're feeling especially fantastic, you can even like this video, because it's time for us to dive into the wonderful world of Skyrim after 10 glorious years. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for us to begin. Oh, Skyrim. Oh, 10 years on and it's pretty much the exact same, except you can no longer get glitched on a bird that flies through here and have your horse and carriage carried away into the stratosphere. That was one of my favorite bugs, but sadly they patched that one rather quick. However, there's a huge amount that they just quite simply didn't patch, and that's what we're going to be messing about with today. We're going to be basically transforming our character into becoming an immortal, and there's going to be pretty much no way to stop us. But best of all, the effort it's actually going to take is ridiculously lacking. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen. It's time for Skyrim to begin. We've made it to the end of the line, and naturally Raelof's gonna run off and get an arrow yeeted into his back. Ah, Skyrim, how I've missed you. Alright, now it's time for us to actually make and play a character. A character so truly powerful, they're going to make it to the end of this game and beat it using all of the magical tricks that only a developer would know. Consequently, it only makes sense for us to play the god of Skyrim himself, Todd Howard. And here he is, ladies and gentlemen. Oh my goodness, the perfect realization of Todd Howard in this universe. Yes, he's a little bit more buff than he is in the real world, but that's because Todd is actually buff on the inside, where it counts, in his heart, his personality, and his bank account. So it's time for us to finish and name this lovely character, the one, the only, Todd Howard, who's going to be using all of the wonderful tricks of the trade to actually save the world of Skyrim that he created. Let's begin. Anyway, it's time for us to get killed by a dragon, which always feels a bit weird because I'm half expecting Thomas the Tank Engine to fly over, and wabam, that's one head off. Oh, and here comes in, sadly not Thomas the Tank Engine, but oh well. Ah, we now finally get freedom. Right, now fantastic. We get our decision. Do we join the Imperials or the Rebellion? Naturally, we join the Imperials because the Rebellion are just an absolute bunch of mad lads that don't really know what they're doing. So it's into here we go with Hadvar. Anyway, he's gonna untie our hands, which is perfect. Now, we're gonna steal some of the equipment and just equip ourselves, and then we need to get started on our lovely journey. Right, now we've made it to one of the classical points in the game, which is the point where we find the cave bear. Now, of course, the cave bear is a wonderful point in the game because it allows you to actually, you know, max out your sneak level. We simply need to crouch and walk into the wall in one endless spot, vaguely where the bear might be able to see us, but of course can't see us. And as you can see, we start out with level 15 sneak, but if we just keep running against this wall like so, our sneak increases. Magical. It really is as easy as that, ladies and gentlemen. Right, so I'm just gonna whack on the auto run key and then just AFK for about an hour or two. And when we come back, Todd Howard will be a god of sneaking. Right, okay. I've been running against the wall now for I think about 2 hours, and I've come back and we have maxed out our sneak level, which is fantastic because it now means I can do something like this, which is to have a 3x damage modifier when sneaking with bows. Oops, that arrow missed. And guess we just go again. There we go. And that one hits. Lovely. The bear is dead. Fantastic stuff. Onwards with our adventure, Hadvar. Now we're gonna have Todd pick up the magic skill stone because why not. We're going to have him max out some magic stats. But in the meantime, we need to work on a few of Todd's, you know, limiting mortal factors. One being that Todd can currently die, which might make doing the main questline a little bit tedious if Todd is, you know, being murdered by gigantic monstrous monstrosities. So we need to make Todd an immortal. Now, there's a few ways you can make characters immortals. We could do the Fortify Restoration exploit loop, but as that is usually my go-to Skyrim exploit, I actually won't be doing that today. Nope, instead we're going to be finding another way to stack enchantment and modifiers in order to make Todd an immortal. It's using a very simple strategy that will effectively mean that Todd is going to be wearing 700,000 different items of clothing. Oh, and we've just been invited to join the Dawn Guard. Oh dear, fantastic. Yes, I forgot, Todd Howard, after just leaving Helgen, is now ready to join the Dawn Guard. That is, of course, something we're not going to be doing. But also, because we're a little bit stronger, you'll notice that there's actually some better items for sale here, like these lovely steel helmets and steel daggers. So it would actually be quite good if we could have them. Now, the best way for us to do that is if we actually, you know, borrow some items from this lovely trader here. However, we don't really have any money for it. So we need to find a way to get gold and fast. And one of the easiest ways for us to do that is to go into this lovely trader here, and we're gonna steal from Lucan here. What we do is we want to sell an item to this trader here, like say a spider egg. So we just drag it over here into his inventory like so, and then we press E, and now we're inside of the trader's inventory. And what we can do is we can just sell the trader his own stuff. It really is as easy as that. Now we want to find an item like say the steel war axe here, and then just click to sell it. And we can basically just sell it multiple times until the trader doesn't have any money left. And there we go. This actually improves my speech skill because I am just that good at trading. And there we go. We've cleared the trader out of all of his money. We have 836 gold now. Fantastic. But that's not actually enough to buy any gear. And all you want to do to reset a trader's inventory and also cash supply, drop down a quick save, set them on fire, and then load that save. And we're bam. Now that he quickly flipped into being hostile and not hostile, we can repeat the process again. Oh, would you look at that? He suddenly got 750 gold again. So we naturally want to borrow that from him. So we're going to select our lockpick, come over into apparel, E, and then now we can sell him his own stuff. So we're going to sell him an apprentice robe of conjuration, another one and another one, take all of his money and repeat this process until we've got a decent amount of money. Damn thieves! Yeah, as if things weren't bad enough, the only issue is Lucan. Turns out Todd Howard here is a damn thief, as he's just used his incredible beautiful charms to convince you to buy your own product back to you. Oh my goodness, that is classic Todd Howard. And just like that, our trading is complete. We've managed to clear out the trader for around about 18,000 gold. Now we've used that money to actually go and buy ourselves some additional items like this lovely backpack here, and just generally a few supplies that we might need for the road. Now we need to probably grab ourselves some armor. Right, now what we want to do is basically find a way to steal from the Skyforge, one of the greatest loot spawns that the world actually has. Next up, all you want to do is come to this lovely area right here, and you'll see this wall. Now you just want to basically walk against this wall, and you'll notice that you'll start to basically sink into the terrain. That's because this wall doesn't actually exist. So wabam, we are now underneath Whiterun. Lovely stuff. It really is as easy as that. Finally, we need to make our way over to the Skyforge, and for that we're going to probably want to leave Whiterun, so head this way and then out of the city. Right, now after you make your way outside of Whiterun into the cursed Skyrim that hasn't actually loaded because you're technically meant to be inside of Whiterun, make your way over to this area where the ground no longer exists, run along the wall, and basically just make your way down into the Skyforge. Once you make your way underneath the Skyforge like so by running along the wall, you'll notice that there's a magical chest here. This is the chest of the vendor of the Skyforge, so consequently you just want to make your way over to it, jump if you need to, and search it. And wabam, we now have access to the Skyforge chest. And we can actually take everything we want from this. Every single item can be ours. And so naturally, that's exactly what we're going to do. Now, it doesn't matter how many items of armor you get, we're going to be able to use all of them, despite the fact that we probably shouldn't be able to. And now that we've taken everything we could possibly want from the chest, it's time for us to leave. It's not too difficult to do. I mean, we can climb up this rock and we should appear out near the Companions Guild. Yep, we do. Fantastic. Oh, this game. Skyrim, you just quite simply never change, no matter how many times you try. But of course, a whole bunch of armor items isn't going to be enough. We are going to actually want even more. So for that, it's time for us to actually make a visit to Dawnguard and steal from the vendor chest. So I'll be back as soon as I've managed that. And here we are, ladies and gentlemen, all the way over in Dawnstar. Now, have the developers removed this chest from the game? Have they? Nope, of course they haven't. Right, sure. Because why? Why remove exploits from the game? Why? It makes no sense. Okay, fantastic. Right, we're gonna steal this silver helmet. Ooh, this looks brand new and jazzy. Thank you very much. Some very jazzy potions. potions we'll also take. Now, the reason we've collected all of these items of armor is very simple. Normally, the game only lets you wear, you know, one set of armor each. After all, you can only wear one helmet in real life, and if you're walking around with four different sets of chainmail strapped to yourself, you're probably not even going to be able to move. However, Skyrim has some unique gameplay mechanics, and so with all of these armor items that we now have, we're going to be making our way back to Whiterun. Now, what you want to do is come over here in Whiterun to the other guard's barracks. That's right, not the one by the actual front gate. No, this guard's barracks hidden away over here. And you want to break your way inside of it. And by break your way inside of it, I just mean wander in, because no one's going to stop you if you just walk around. Then you want to wander on through here and basically dump all of your armor inside of this lovely barrel. So I'm going to first make sure that I'm actually wearing a full set of armor, which I am successfully doing. There you go, Todd, you look fantastic. And now we're going to just quite simply dump everything else inside of this barrel. So store all of these bad boys. There we go. In you go, my friends. Lovely stuff. Don't worry, we'll be seeing you all again soon. And wabam, in they go. Lovely stuff. Now that they're all placed in there, we have to do one very simple thing. That is to be arrested. So the easiest way to do that, pickpocket a guard and get caught. How are we going to do that? Well, we'll steal his amulet of Dibella here and just apologize. Be asked to get taken to jail. There we go. Now, all you need to do when you get into jail is not sleep. Instead, steal some gold off of the bandit next to you, move him over to the corner, there you go, and pick your way out of this grate. There we go, simple as that. Wabam, we have now escaped. Lovely stuff. Ah, we are one stealthy little sausage. And now that we've made our way to freedom, all we have to do is quite simply wander on around until we get to the escape. Now, what you can do is you can loot this chest here and get all of your personal belongings back. However, we won't be doing that. Basically, all of the items we had on us, and those items being the armor we were wearing and the weapons we had, are stored inside of that chest. But we don't want them. Instead, you're going to simply bypass that, climb up these stairs here and drop on down. And then you're going to climb up out of this ladder here, and you're going to make your way over to the guard barracks. Now, we do have a mission to retrieve our possessions, but we don't need them. Instead, you want to equip yourself an entire new full set of armor. So I'm going to pick up a leather armor of restoration that we're going to take, a silver helmet, fantastic, some silver boots, some silver gauntlets, and we look fantastic now, don't we? Lovely. So what's our next mission? Well, quite simply, we want to get ourselves arrested again. So walk up to the guard. Okay, I guess now we steal his torch. And there we go, we've been caught, and we're now going to go and be taken to jail. There we go, simple as that. And now that we're in the dungeon, all of our armor has been taken away, and we're just going to repeat the process of escape. So I'm just going to steal from the barrel again. Lovely stuff, we look brilliant. And once again, we're just going to wander on in here and steal from a guard. Right, okay, a decent amount of time has passed. I've probably done this route maybe a handful of times now, so we should have a decent large amount of armor waiting for us. Now, in order for us to actually wear it, very simply, instead of escaping, we are just going to sleep inside of the cot and serve our time in jail. And when we are released from prison, all of our armor is going to be now placed on top of us, which is very entertaining because, as you'll notice, it doesn't exactly graphically, it doesn't fit very well, but it doesn't need to fit very well because what we've managed to do is create some kind of weird cursed god character that can now carry 410 units of weight and also has 328 armor. That is because we are wearing all of this, which is pretty darn good because we actually have quite a few effects. If we go over to magic and take a look at our active effects, we can see that our archery is boosted by 25% and then a further 25%. We can carry even more stuff. Our destruction spells are 15% less to cast and magicka regenerates faster. We have even more magicka, and guess what? Restoration spells are cheaper and the magicka regenerates faster. And oh, look at all of this fortified unarmed damage. Our unarmed damage is now actually at 30. That's pretty good. We also regenerate magicka 75% faster again and again. Ah, all of that seems pretty good, especially considering I can now cast a spell and then just simply wait, and magicka just flows straight back in. We have now become a fair little bit of a god, so I'm going to drop down a save file, and then I'm going to hop inside of here and start the main quest, because with 328 units of armor, we're going to be quite difficult to kill. So let's go do the quest for Bleak Falls Barrow. Oh, and ladies and gentlemen, I jumped into the midpoint of the video to give you some fantastic news. That's right, I've spoken to Todd Howard, and he's agreed that for each like on this video, he will release a brand new edition of Skyrim. That's right. So far, there's like 18 different versions if we include the Samsung smart fridge, and with each like you leave on the video, we might have even more versions. One day, I hope we'll get a Soldier Boy game console version of Skyrim. Until then, we can only dream. So make sure to do your part and make the Soldier Skyrim a reality by liking the video. Anyway, onwards with our exploits. Alright, so we we've completed Bleak Falls Barrow, and now it is time for us to actually fight our first dragon. I know, it's very exciting. I've got my lovely dwarven bow here with my dwarven arrows, and also my ability to do magic with pretty much no repercussions whatsoever. So we're just going to wander inside the keep here and summon a dragon for us to fight. Here comes a big old dragony boy, so it's time for us to kill him. Oh, hello, hello, hello. Anyway, I'm just going to keep hitting you, and that should do fine. There we go, increase my archery, and it's dead. Lovely, I've killed it. Fantastic. Right, now let us loot it and then absorb its soul. Lovely. Tasty, tasty dragon soul. My favorite snack. Right, okay. I've done a few of the main quest lines, and our next quest is the Diplomatic Immunity quest. It's a little bit of back and forth. We have to basically organize a party, get inside the Falmor Embassy, and do a little bit of sneaking around. However, in reality, you don't need to do that. No, 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 no. You just need to get yourself a nice, good bucket. Like this bucket right here. This is a good bucket. Then make your way to the side wall of the Falmor Embassy, just walk up against it, and wabam, just as easy as that, you're inside the Falmor Embassy. Now, we just need to grab ourselves some very important information, so inside we go. Let me quickly just yeet this guard in the back of the head. Wabam, there you go. Yeet. Then we just need to basically steal all of these lovely bits of information. Fantastic. And there we go. We've actually pretty much finished off the Diplomatic Immunity quest. Now, all we need to do is make our way back to Riverwood, which we can do by fast traveling, and that's a lovely large amount of the game basically just skipped in a matter of minutes instead of it taking literal hours. Oh, okay, ladies and gentlemen, some time has passed. I've managed to do a whole bunch of quests, and now we are on the quest to get the Elder Scroll. There's just one issue. In order to get the Elder Scroll, you have to dive into a bunch of dwarven ruins and do a whole bunch of fighting. It's a really, really, really fun quest, but remember, ladies and gentlemen, come on, we're on a tight schedule today. So what we're going to do is crouch on down and just glitch against this wall here until we get the lovely little pop-up that we can actually escape our way into the undercity of this lovely dwarven world. All you have to do is get a hold of this little cog here, press E, and get teleported down. And here we go, we've just bypassed a huge amount of the game and made our way straight into the chamber where we can nab ourselves an Elder Scroll. Lovely stuff. So now that we've made our way to the lovely Elder Scrolls area, we can actually steal ourselves an Elder Scroll without doing most of the game. We do, of course, need the blank lexicon, which you can get from Septimus Cygnus out on the ice sheets by just talking to him. You don't need to go to the College of Winterhold. That's completely useless. And now that you've made your way to the lovely gigantic boy, what you're going to do is drop in the lovely blank lexicon, and then we can do our little bit of jiggery pokery to wiggle this bad boy around, and then we'll bam, press that bad boy, and we've got ourselves an Elder Scroll, ladies and gentlemen. It's as easy as that. Ah, glorious, beautiful magic. All right, now let's go read this thing that blinds people. And here we go. Lovely. We're using the Elder Scroll, traveling through time, doing the time warp. Here we go. And now we're going to go and learn the Dragon Wrench Shout from the Nord Heroes. And there we go. We've learned how to do the Dragon Wrench Shout. And there we go. Job done. We've learned how to do it. Oh, and Alduin has now arrived. Lovely. And he wants to kill us, which is lovely. That's very nice of him. Poor Parfenax. He's not very good at combat, bless him. But hey, I can do a little bit of dragon rend. Alright, so down he comes. Now I just have to punch on him as if he's some kind of regular chumpy boy, because hey, he kind of is. Alright, now swing and swing and swing. Hey, no, no, back down you come. You're not getting away. There we go. Fantastic. Lovely. You are one angry boy, my friend. One big old angry boy. But it's okay. I don't even need a health potion to kill you. You're actually surprisingly easy to murder. And there we go. Alduin is basically done now. He is going to go yeet off into the skies, and that's pretty much the end of him, at least a little while, as I've got to go to a completely different plane of existence. Anyway, let's go speak to a grumpy dragon up here. Hello, Parfenax. Right, and there we go. We've now basically got our mission, which is to convince the Jarl of Whiterun to allow us to house a dragon inside of Dragon's Reach, so we can then basically have that dragon betray Alduin, and then we can go and kill Alduin for real this time. I know, it's a complicated set of jiggery pokery, but it had to be done. All right, now I guess it's time for me to summon myself a dragon to fight. And away we go. Dragon has been called. Let's see if he answers. Here comes that boy. Look at him go. He's beautiful. All right, I'll hit it with a little dragon rend. So he's got to come down now. And now there's an interesting thing you can do. Yes, you can fight him, but actually all you need to do is just leave. That's right. You could kill him, but it's actually much, much easier just to quite simply walk into Dragon's Reach and then leave Dragon's Reach again and go back into the hall. And if you do that, ladies and gentlemen, something magical happens.
Yes.
Ah, look at that. He's just been captured. It really is as easy as that. Ah, hello, Odvig. You've been captured. Oh, bless you, my little friend. All right, now my mission is very simple. I just have to set the dragon free, and then all I have to do is fly with him to Sovngarde. So let's go free ourselves this dragon and then ride it into the sunset. So we open up the trap, and then we're now going to ride on him. Lovely stuff. Ah, right, we're riding on a magical dragon. Oh, this is beautiful, Todd. This is truly, truly beautiful. So from this point on, it's a pretty simple challenge. I've just got to make my way through this glorious dungeon. So I guess I'll whip out my bow, stealth on up, and kill a skeleton or two. All right, up I go. Come on, up we go. Enter into Sovngarde. Yep, there's some really angry boys here, including Narkin, who is, I'm pretty sure, something like a dragony princey boy. He's got a special little thing. He's very angry. I guess I should probably activate some scrolls or something. Let's do a little firestorm and release. Oh, that was fantastic. Next up, we're going to hit a scroll of blizzards on Narkin here. Come on. Let me cast it. Oh, for goodness sake, everyone's just killing Narkin right now. Oh, right. Narkin is dead. So, right, we can take his dragon priest stuff. We'll take his money and we'll also take this. Plus 50% magicka and destruction and restoration spells cost 20% less. Fantastic. That's lovely. Right, now I want to go to Sovngarde, please, dragons. Oh, this is taking a lot of health potions, but it had to be done. Very angry, healthy boys. Okay, activate the dragon seal. Come on. Right, there we go. Job done. Yep, I know you're there, dragons. I know you're there. Oh, it really is as easy as that. Todd, you're doing an absolutely splendid job, my friend. Right, now let's go find out how to defeat Alduin in the wonderful world of Sovngarde. Oh, there's Alduin. There you go. Look at him go. Fantastic. Anyway, we made it all the way to the lovely hall. Here we go. Fantastic. Here's a lovely guy who tried to slay Alduin. And now Sun wants to murder us, and that's okay, because all we have to do is murder Sun back, and he's really not the worst thing in the universe. And there we go. We've been admitted. So there we go. Into the lovely hall of the dead we go. Hoppity, hoppity, hoppity. Fantastic stuff. Over the dragon we go. And fantastic. We've made it all the way to the end. Into the hall of valor we get. Ah, Sovngarde. It's a lovely place. All right, so we're going to help the heroes of Sovngarde dispel Alduin's mist, and then I think that means we do get to now fight him as well. So out we go with the lovely heroes. Time for another glorious battle. Oh, Sovngarde is just downright beautiful. What a lovely place. And there we go. We clear the skies. The map looks absolutely lovely, and I think Alduin's going to start heading our way now. And there we go. Fantastic. It is now time for us to defeat Alduin once and for all. So we're going to need a little bit of dragon rend here. And here comes Alduin. Lovely. Where is that Alduin-y boy? Here he is. All right, and there we go. He gets dragon rended. Lovely stuff. Now let's equip the dragon's bane and get to work. We've got some fun swinging to do. All right, Alduin, get down onto the bloody ground where I can hit you. Thank you, Alduin. Yep, you can nibble me, but you don't actually do that much damage. And nope, you're not going anywhere. You're landing straight back down. Come on, Alduin. Come back down, my friend. There we go. And swing and hit and swing and hit. And there we go. Alduin is really getting minced up now. He should be dead any moment now. And there we go. I have defeated him. Glorious. Oh, rest in peace. And there we go. He's dead. Ah, lovely. What a majestic journey. We are now a true dragon slayer. We even get an achievement for that. Right, and there we go. We've been hailed by everyone. It has been a lovely fight. Anyway, back into the world of regular Skyrim we go, and we made it. Ooh, there's a lot of dragons now. Hello, dragons. Are we friendly now? Parfenax, will you agree that I'm friendly? There goes most of the dragons. And there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. We actually beat Skyrim. I know, it was completely perfectly balanced and fair. At no point did we ever manipulate Todd Howard's glorious creation to give ourselves maybe a minor advantage. Just a small one. Anyway, now that I've actually got to play Skyrim Anniversary Edition, I've been filled with hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of ideas of how to break this game further, because there's so many more modifiers and effects now added to the game that can be exploited and broken. So many new items, so many new quest lines, all with ways that can be exploited, glitched, and manipulated for our glorious benefit. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, this has been the adventure of the glorious Todd Howard. He who not only created Skyrim, but has defeated it. What a man. What a glorious, glorious, beautiful man. As always, ladies and gentlemen, if you enjoyed today's video, you are legally required to give it a like and go down into the comment section and pledge your undying allegiance to our Lord and Savior, the creator of all of Skyrim, Todd Howard. Although actually, you can leave a meaningful message there. Tell me if you actually managed to beat Skyrim. I genuinely want to know if you've actually managed to finish the main quest of Skyrim, because I think I'll be pleasantly surprised by the amount of people who never did it like me. Anyway, thank you very much for watching, ladies and gentlemen. And hey, if you sat there and you're interested in something that's kind of a bit new and exciting, then say hello to my brand new podcast. That's right, I made a podcast. It's called The Weekly Domestic. It features myself and my lovely, wonderful fiance, and we talk about our relationship, something we got up to new that week. We also solve other people's relationship problems in the most useful way possible. Like, for example, the problem that was given to us by a fan. What do you do if your girlfriend finds your D&D character more attractive than you? Now, that's a spicy topic that has to be solved. But naturally, the reason I'm bringing it up is because this entire video will be getting talked about on the podcast. That's right, in our lovely third episode, both myself and my fiancé challenged ourselves to actually beat the entire main storyline of Skyrim, because neither of us have done it before. So why not give that a watch? I'll include links to all of that down in the description. It's available on all lovely, amazing platforms. As always, a massive thank you to each and everyone for our amazing patrons whose names you see listed on screen now. Seriously, all of them are absolutely fantastic. Anyway, thank you very much for watching, ladies and gentlemen. I'll see each and every one of you in the next one. Have a lovely day, and goodbye for now.